Hello everyone. Well, as much I like pub, it's a really nice place to practice trick steps and practice your aim as well. But I do like Highlander quite a lot more. It's a lot more different. More important picks, well, they really count. This clip here, I use the cloak and dagger, mainly because I want to get picks on the cart. Here they don't check and it seems like they're distracted as well, so I go in. Works out quite well. Once again, just trying to wait for opportunities. I just want to focus the cart at this point since we are defending and I really just wanted to use quite a lot of time to getting to this first point here. Here the engineer is in the cart and there comes the demo once again on the cart. And well, they don't check behind them and they're also kind of distracted, so I go for it. Get two more very easy picks. Here again, using cloak and dagger, I go in with my disguise and I skip the sniper, obviously because he's using the razorback, and go for the demo. Here I cloak and go around the corner but jumps back and sit pretty much down where the heavy did check. People usually don't check the same place twice. I was thinking about going for the sniper, but a pyro got him on his side here, and demo jumped in, he's distracted, so he makes my job very easy. If you're around your teammates, I would say you should use your gun and try to deal some damage helping them out. Also, if you're using dead rear, you really got no excuse to not use your gun. Dead rear, well, you can play very aggressive with it, but unlike the invincible watch and cloak and dagger, you can't really hide somewhere, just pop out and get the very, very important picks. And when you're using Deadringer, sometimes you have to do some acting and rely on your distractions. Here, I backpedal when I cross the lines, and demo doesn't react to me, so makes my job very easy. Here again, I finish off, I think it is a demo, so get pretty much a free pick, but again in Highlander, it really doesn't matter about how many picks you get, it's more about what picks you get and when you get them. After a bit of fade away, I would say many times it's smarter to go off your pocket than your medic. A medic can be all alone and one of them, just call him out. And during Critskrieg, also going for the pocket instead of medic. This is very important, especially if you don't have no other option. But if you don't get it, you can still, well, pretty much distract the pocket and make them waste more time getting you than getting your teammates. So when you're using the deadman, you can pretty much be a distraction yourself. When you are close to people, many times it's smart to just use your knife and hope that we get a backstab. And this medic, he's damaged, so cover the gun and lucky enough to actually get a headshot on him. When your team is pushing, it's really good time to go in action and you can get really easy picks since, well, they are very, very distracted. And I know there's a sentry in the corner, so that's the reason why I actually go back there. Sentry goes down, so I decide to try to cap the point and help deal as much damage as I can. And if you actually end up getting the cap there. When you get spotted out, I would really say try to get as much damage out as you can, especially against class that it's really hard to escape from. Well, I was capable of predicting the heaviest moment and got a really easy pick on him. And engineers, when they are running their sentry, sometimes you could just zap the sentry and shoot him and easily get the NG and the sentry down that way. But here, in this clip, I'm chasing the NG, reason because I know there's teammates around and I really don't want him to damage him. And he also happened to have the crate, so I saved our sniper here. And sniper is really nice to have on this last phase here. He can get really, really big picks. And well, since the medic and demo went to the side, and I know there's a lot of people in spawn, I go for the cap and hope that they will not get out in time. It works out pretty well. After you get a medic pick, you will usually get called out, and since you get called out, well, you usually can't do too much because the pyro will probably spy check quite a lot. So here I just decide to go back to the spawn and wait for the medic to spawn and try to get a spawn kill on him. It's pretty really nice to keep the med down. It's preventing the enemy team from healing and building Uber. With a dead ring, you can do quite a lot of acting, but you must not forget, you can do the same with the Invincible Arch. Here, I skipped the demo since I really just want to get this heavy out. And the sniper kind of helps me to make them bleed my sky. I bump into heavy, so there I pretty much have to go before I the stab. I was lucky enough to get him down. Sniper get the energy, and the demo is all alone. And I hope that he distracted him, and he was, so I just go for the stab. When a pirate spots you out, it's not always the smartest thing to do is just run away. Sometimes, well, a little bit of elevation can save you, and get a really easy jump stab on him. And here, it's the same pyro as well, trying to go for the cone first since he is at a distance. But I ended up running away. He saw me using his gun, so I go for a corner stab. There, act like I didn't see him, and time it, and get it right. In this situation, I want to get a sentry at his round corner. The demo spells me out, so I'm forced to go into action. Lucky enough, the engineer picked up the sentry. And yeah, I got a kind of a weird stab on him. I thought first it was a face stab, but actually, yeah, I was able to get behind him. And get a really nice stab. And once again, getting just lucky. They were distracted and Matt didn't see me coming up. I was lucky enough to drop Zebra. And once again, he when using the cloak and dagger in competitive, it's really really nice. It makes you able to do a lot of things that you otherwise can't do with the Deadwinger. Call out enemy's position, the medic's Hebrew percentage, and yeah, calling out if they are also got a sentry or not. Also what medic gun the medic is using, that is also a really nice thing you can do. The engineer doesn't spot me, so I just go for it, and he doesn't seem to communicate the medic and the heavy, so I was able to get a heavy as well. Communicating when you're playing Highlander is a really big thing. You can avoid people dying because of that. Here, stab. I get a stab on the spy after he goes to the teleporter. I waited just in case the medic goes to the teleporter, and he did. Communication can really save your teammates. This is pretty normal setup in Highlander at this phase of Battlewater. The engineers usually build dispensers to prevent the spy to get up. He didn't build it right, so replace it right. So I was able to get over it, and I got the engineer and his sentry. Get spotted out pretty heavy there, so I'm just waiting on the dispenser, see him coming, so I go back again to relocate, and also I want to check if the sniper is around to see if I can get him down. Sniper isn't around, the med and heavy is up there, so I'm thinking about going for them. Now, I avoid stabbing the dispenser, so the engineer can't call out my position. And I was able to get a combo, once again. But I still don't want the dispenser up there to heal their teammates. So, zap it. Well, here I really kind of stress a little bit. The med is very low health and can only take one headshot. I don't hit him, so the pyro comes, so I'm trying to run away. Flames hit me after the dead ring activate, so I'm getting forced to go for a stab here. Some trick stabs are planned, but others are just comes from pure muscle memory. In the scout here, I go one way and then immediately the other one. I was lucky enough to him turning in the direction I hope they would turn. And oh, dead ring, you can't really go invisible, but you can still hide and come out from unexpected places. Saw that the pyro was up there, I'm hoping he wouldn't see me. I was lucky enough. And same with the demo, I heard that he was still up, and also saw him the first time he went up, so I really want to get him down. If you're using the Bastard, I would say you should go for headshots if people are below 100 HP or below 102. Since you can get sometimes really easy picks because of that. And scout dome, I missed the headshot and I missed all of my other shots. So, kind of backing up, the engine just have to jump right on me. I was a little bit lucky getting summoning. Also, jumping targets, sometimes you could just show them who's the boss and get a headshot on him. They have changed quite a lot, and you can also sometimes just pick him off after you have landed. As I said in my first video, spawn camping in Highlander can be sometimes very dangerous. The soldier here, he spots me out, so I'm getting forced to go after something. The heavy goes after spawn, and I was lucky enough that he didn't turn the right direction. Here I didn't see the spy when I did the cloak, and I would see if you spot a spy, use your gun, because you can easily get backstabbed by the other one with spy. I really want to keep that distance. And here, the medic goes up, I'm going after him. Lucky enough the scout didn't see me, so I go for it. Medic is really a nice pick too, always get in Highlander, and he is also your main target. Thank you for watching, and hopefully I will see you soon.